off last night. Instead, I'm back in my village because, well, let's face it, I died horribly to Suto the last two times I fought him. And there are two health capsules that are much in need of acquiring. Turns out, you can make that jump. Just hop over here. Don't do that. Let's try that again. This is not starting off on a good note, is it? I made the jump once off camera, then once on camera, and now I'm never going to be able to do it again. Watch. That's well done. Now let's try a little more troll jump. Here all week, folks. There. Three more HP. Now let's. Well, so that you don't have to watch me, I'm going to pause and let's go get that one in the pipe works. Alright, we're back in the pipeworks on this little intersection. Let's get that life capsule. Not do that. There's gotta be some trick to it. I will figure this out. That's close. That's gotta be right on the right track. That's more like it. Alright. Well, I'll spare you the walk out of here, and we'll see you back when I get back to Suto. Alright. Let's get this show back on the road. Hello there, Suto. I guess that resets the speed of the text if you close the game. Alright, let's try this. horses. Doing better times before, but not better enough apparently. So close. Just ran out of ammo. Thank you. Finally got him! Huzzah! Got the Grass Town data card. Finally! Good grief. And there goes the floor. Just like Jack warned us. Oh, hey, there's a treasure chest. It blew me away from the treasure chest. What? No, actually, I knew that was gonna happen. I have gotten this far in the original. The save point is all the way over there. What I wouldn't give for the booster of the machine gun right now. So yeah, here we are. The underside of the island. If you fall, obviously, game over. We're unarmed, so it's kind of a rehash of first cave, except not. I don't think there are very many enemies here. There are, however, plenty of, well, challenging jumps and similar. There is also that. Yeah, you'll be seeing a lot of this throughout the entire game. For the moment, it's being helpful. I don't imagine it will stay that way. Hello there, Mr. Cthulhu. What do you have to say?
That old witch Jenka must really believe in you. Genesis usually isn't this predictable.
Got the fireball! It's not the polar star, but the fireball is a pretty cool weapon. So, we are armed. It's the fireball with its measly two balls on screen, but hey, we're armed. That's gotta mean something. Yeah, you'll need to be careful around those moving blocks. Outer wall in the original game, with its weird subjective gravity for items? Yeah, you'll be seeing that here. The problem with the Genesis thing that Cthulhu mentioned is that it has a tendency to close things off if you're not quick and or careful. So, if we're not careful and don't keep our eyes open, this could very well be a bunch of lost forever weaponry and bonuses and stuff like that. I think we're good for now, though. The game starts out, at least from what I remember, on easy mode, essentially. It waits a bit to throw the trickier platform at you. Come on, come here. Nevertheless, a fall is still a fall, and these bats are not helpful. Alright, here we are. Welcome to the Sand Zone. The You hear that? That's certain sections filling up with sand. We're going to be seeing a lot of that. But for now, we'll go ahead and stop here. See you next time on Cave Story, Jenka's Nightmare.